Let's look at the measures of central tendency, the mean, the median, and the mode, and also compare them. So let's say you're looking to draft a running back for your fantasy football league. And here is the game logs for rushing yards, in this case our data set, for a player you're thinking about drafting over a previous 16-game season. We're going to quickly calculate the mean, median, and mode and compare them for rushing yards per game for this player. To calculate the mean or average, we add up all the values and divide by the total number of values. Adding them up, we get 1,307, and there are 16 total values. So 1,307 divided by 16 equals 81.7. which is the mean rushing yards per game for this player. Now for the median, which is the middle value, or between the middle values. Since we have 16 total values and an even number of values, it will be between the middle values. We will arrange the values in ascending or increasing order, draw a line here in the middle where we have 8 values lower and 8 values higher, and add these two middle values together and divide that total by 2, which gives us 74.5, which is our median. Now for the mode, which is the value that occurs most in the data set. Looking through, we see that 43 is the most occurring value, twice. So our mode is 43. So 81.7 is the mean, 74.5 is the median, and 43 is our mode. In comparing the three of these, we see the mode is extremely low, and the median and mean are kind of close. So the mode is probably not the best tool to use in evaluating this running back. In this case, I would use the mean or the median to evaluate this running back to compare him to other running backs and their means and medians. All three of these tools can be influenced by the skew of the data. For instance, a symmetrical distribution, as you see in this graph, has some high and some low values and some values in between. So the mean, median, and mode will lie near the middle. In a positively skewed distribution, the higher values in the data set will pull the mean upwards. The median will be less than the mean and more towards the center of the graph, and the mode will be less than the median, more towards the peak of the graph. And in a negatively skewed distribution, the lower values will pull the mean downwards, the median will again be near the center of the graph, higher than the mean, and the mode will be the highest of the three, near the peak of the graph. Alright my friends, as you can see, each of these three different tools can give you a different kind of perspective on a data set. So it's always good to take a look at them when you're analyzing a data set. Hopefully this video helped you out. I do have more videos right there for you. Till next time, I am out of here.